And it's just continuing to do this, the chant of murderers.
Greetings, everyone. My name is Lita Holborn. I am the National Vice President of the Public and Commercial Services Union, PCS Union. I want to start by giving my sincere condolences on behalf of my trade union to everybody impacted, the survivors, the families who have lost loved ones, people in the community, local residents, everybody that's impacted, and to say that we give our full solidarity and support to everybody impacted. Over the past few weeks, I've met and spoken with a number of survivors and local residents and local members of the community, and it's quite clear that there's been disarray in terms of the response to what happened. But what we know as well is that local residents living in Grenfell Tower had for many years been raising concerns with the local authority about the things that led to the fire, and not only were they disregarded and ignored, there was an attempt by the local authority to shut them down and shut their voices down, which is an absolute disgrace. And some of those people lost their lives in the tower. This is a disgrace that there was actually legal action threatened against some of those individuals for raising legitimate concerns on behalf of the tenants of Grenfell Tower about serious health and safety issues which should have been taken seriously. The local authority have a responsibility. We're talking about one of the wealthiest boroughs in Europe who are concerned with the wealthy people in the borough, but not the working class people in the borough. And what residents have told me, and survivors have told me, is that what they're really concerned about is to have their lives back on track. Most people haven't even been able to grieve for the people they've lost, whether that's been family members, whether it's been neighbours and friends, because their life is upside down. And most people want secure housing. They don't want to have to move and move. We've heard stories, well, not stories, but heard the facts from those directly impacted about the fact that they've been offered accommodation that's outside of the borough, that's far away, which will isolate them from the local community and the local schools and the local support networks and their families, which is an absolute disgrace. Some people will say that this issue is not political, but I say it's very political. Everything about what happened in the lead up to the fire itself, and what's happened since is political. And as well as being from the PCS Union, I'm also the chair of Black Activists Rising Against Cuts, which is an anti-austerity organisation. And since we were founded 7 years ago, we have been campaigning and speaking out about the fact that the cuts that have been made to the most deprived and poorest communities, working class communities, diverse communities, will have a detrimental impact on lives and on futures. And we've seen that come to fruition. We should never have to have seen what happened to people in Grenfell Tower. The fact that cuts to services have been made, cuts to local authorities have been made, the cuts that have been made to the fire service and other essential services, and also cutting corners by using cladding that was flammable, that took lives without any responsibility. The local authority has to be held accountable, and so has everybody that has a responsibility for everybody that died and everybody that's been displaced at Grenfell Tower and on the local estate. We need to stand up to that. We can't be silent. Yes, what happens in terms of a justice campaign must be led by those who are directly impacted. But at this moment in time, most people aren't in a position to seek justice. They need a secure roof over their heads. They need to know that their children can get back on track and have a normal routine, not be living in a hotel for months on end. They need their lives back. There's all this money that's been collected. Most of the response has been by the community. Why hasn't that money been evenly distributed between people? People deserve dignity and respect, not to be having to chase handouts, to chase clothes, to chase food. Those things should be coming to them, but they should have the money in their hand so they have the dignity to spend that money as they see fit and as is necessary. It's unacceptable, and so whilst we must be led by the people that are directly impacted, in the meantime, we all have a responsibility, whether we're the local community, the London community. What happened, in terms of the public inquiry, how is that public inquiry representative of the community is supposed to be inquiring about? There needs to be diversity. The people that are advising on that inquiry need to represent the makeup of the local community. There needs to be experts in terms of fire and health and safety. I have been speaking to the fire brigade union in the last couple of weeks because people are concerned that there's been no health and safety or fire tests carried out in terms of looking at risk assessments and what risks there are to them in terms of what's coming down from the tower, in terms of potential fires, exit routes with lots of parts of the estate cut off. It's not acceptable, it's not good enough, and we need to stand up and speak out and stand in solidarity with the local community, with the residents, with the survivors, and particularly for those who have lost loved ones. They need our full support. Solidarity.
Thank you, Zita. BCS.
No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Justice for Grenfell.
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 No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
Kensington and Chelsea Council. Kensington and Chelsea Council. Kensington and Chelsea Council. Okay, before I call the next speaker.